Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. The hugely successful first flight test on December 5th of NASA's Orion spacecraft took it farther than any spacecraft designed for astronauts has been in more than 40 years, with people around the country keeping a close eye on its spaceflight. The two-orbit 4.5-hour trip into space, designed to test many of Orion's systems critical to crew safety, concluded with a capsule's splashdown in the Pacific Ocean about 600 miles southwest of San Diego and recovery by a team of NASA, U.S. Navy, and Lockheed Martin personnel aboard the USS Anchorage. Final destination for NASA's new deep space capsule is Kennedy Space Center in Florida, where its first journey to space began, so engineers can evaluate data recorded during the flight by more than 1,200 onboard sensors. Orion will open up the space between Earth and Mars for exploration by astronauts and testing of the capabilities and technologies needed for future human missions to Mars. NASA announced on December 8th that observations by NASA's Curiosity Mars rover of the lowest sedimentary layers of the red planet's Mount Sharp indicate the mountain was built by sediments deposited in a large lake bed over tens of millions of years. This working interpretation implies that ancient Mars had a climate that could have produced a series of long-lasting lakes at many locations, much larger and longer lasting than any previously confirmed by close-up investigation on Mars. After a voyage of nearly 9 years and 3 billion miles, about two-thirds of which have been spent in hibernation, NASA's New Horizons spacecraft received a wake-up call on December 6th to prepare for its long-awaited encounter next year with the Pluto system.
It's been a long road, and getting from there to here.
New Horizons, which woke to the song Where My Heart Will Take Me, is currently more than 2.9 billion miles from Earth. Its voyage to Pluto will be the farthest any space mission has ever traveled to reach its primary target. A test article of a futuristic hybrid wing body aircraft was unloaded December 11th for evaluation at Langley Research Center. The uniquely shaped fuselage cross-section, manufactured by Boeing, is made from a low-weight, damage-tolerant stitched composite called Pultruded Rod Stitch Deficient Unitized Structure, or Perseus, which will enable new developments in unique aircraft shape and design. Structural testing is part of NASA's Environmentally Responsible Aviation Project to reduce aircraft fuel consumption, noise levels, and emissions through revolutionary design and manufacture of tomorrow's aircraft. And that's what's up this week at NASA. A programming note, starting December 19th, we'll air the special 2014 This Year at NASA Year in Review. Then we're back on January 9th with the first episode of This Week at NASA for 2015. Until then, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.